for the association and wishing everyone a very, very happy Children's Day. And Alia's just come from an event with a lot of kids, so she's like bubbly, cheerful and all of that. So, films and fashion have traditionally been, what do I call it, soulmates. I mean, right from Audrey Hepburn to, say, Robert Redford to Tom Cruise. So it's always been a marriage of fashion and films as far as the West has been concerned. And Filmfare thought it only opposite, you know, we've been going through a transition in covers, fashion, and while retaining the core of Bollywood. So while retaining the core of Bollywood, we started the Absolut, Elyx, Glamour and Style Awards. And happily to say that she's been constantly winning every poll on our... You just have to put most glamorous youth icon, fashion forward, debutante. It's Alia Bhatt who wins most of our polls. And yes, I am very, very prejudiced and biased when it comes to Alia, because Alia is Alia, she's special. And I must add that the promos of Girls in the Game, as usual, she's sensational. So she's just so lovely. I always sort of fall short of words. So Alia is special, and she's here to unveil the latest Filmfare cover for which she won the Youth Icon Award. So without much ado, I'll hand the mic to Alia Bhatt.
That was such a unique introduction. How did you come up with that? Since we've done this a couple of times and you've always had to introduce me, you always come up with these new ways of introducing me, I must say, Jitesh.
Alia also has a, now she can become an interviewer, so you'll see her in very, very different avatars.
No, but I'm very happy to be here, and thank you guys, I'm sorry to keep you waiting if I have,
Yeah, I must say, Alia, when she does a photo shoot, while she's very fashion forward and all that, she never, like a lot of stars that I know, she doesn't ask for final approvals of pictures. She's not bothered. And I have to vouch that even this time, I was like, it's a surprise, it'll be a nice cover. Just be quiet and do the cover. So she, and then she took off to Singapore, so we really didn't have time to interact.
It's okay, you don't have to give a justification. I've said it's fine.
But I'm just saying, you're so.
जीवन साथी हॉट हो या ना हो अच्छा साथी होना चाहिए फनी होना चाहिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल होना चाहिए और हाँ स्वीट होना चाहिए और मुझसे बहुत प्यार करना चाहिए
हाय या आलिया आर्यमन वॉच इंडिया टीवी टाइम्स
हेलो हेलो
डू यू फील फैशन इज लाइक अ वर्जिनिटी बबल टुडे यू हैव अ न्यू ट्रेंड एवरी सेकंड डे कमिंग अप एंड हाउ डू
इट्स लाइक अ व्हाट बबल
वर्चुअलिटी वर्जिनिटी बबल
Virginity bubble.
Yeah.
This is the first time I'm hearing a term like that.
Exactly. So.
Okay, you can just explain.
Fashion is a virginity bubble wherein every second day you have a new fashion trend coming up. So, how do you relate yourself to the fashion trends and how much do you add value to this virginity bubble?
Okay, so, I mean, yeah, the trends will keep changing. I don't think they change every second day. I mean, there are more trends more often than not. And also now I feel because of social media and because of the information age, were aware of these various trends. Since I'm a youthful person, since I'm a youth icon, sometimes even I don't know of certain trends that are up and about because there's so many out there. The way I relate myself to fashion, like Jitesh said, movies and fashion, the industry and fashion, you know, have a beautiful relationship. They go hand in hand. So me being a girl, me being an actor, being an actress especially, I love to doll up. I love to dress up. I relate myself to the trends the way they fit me. I won't go for a trend just because they're a happening trend at that time. I'll only make that my own if I feel like it suits my personality. Making a fashion statement and having a style statement is all about your personality and the person that you are. I feel just following trends like a blind, you know, person, it does not ever serve the purpose. You have to have a direction to the trends that you follow.
Okay, most celebs and actors have a repertoire of stylists who keep giving them new designs and trends to follow. How much is your contribution toward your branding image as being a fashion icon? How much contribution do you give to that? And plus, you have a Sonam Kapoor who introduced a choker which she keeps wearing. So do you feel that you should be actually coming up with a style statement which has the Alia Bhatt tag to it?
Oh, I think if I don't try and make it happen, as opposed to people just point it out for me as the Alia Bhatt trend, then I think that's a way cooler trend as opposed to me trying to make anything happen. Like there was a time period where I was doing a lot of braids in my hair. And then people just started talking about how braids have become my thing. I didn't make it my trend because I wanted braids to be my trend. I just was enjoying that time period and then it happened to be that. So I don't think I'll ever force it. But if it does happen to become something that I do, then it's great because it's always nice to associate just one face and one name with something related to fashion.
Okay, one last question is, what do you feel is more sexy on you? Is it a sari or is it a bikini?
Pajamas. No, I'll go for the third option. Pajamas. Because they're the most effortless and easy. See, bikini can be sexy because you're showing skin, but I don't necessarily believe that is sexy. Sari, I've not explored as much because I've done probably one film where I've worn a lot of saris. I'm still younger. But pajamas, I know, look very sexy on me. So I'll go with pajamas.
Hi, Alia. Hi.